डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर ऑन द लेक्चर नंबर 28, दैट इज जियो थर्मल एनर्जी ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट रिन्यूएबल पावर जनरेशन। वी आर नाउ गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द जियो थर्मल एनर्जी। द वर्ल्ड जियो थर्मल कम्स फ्रॉम द ग्रीक वर्ड, दैट इज जियो दैट मीन्स अर्थ एंड थर्म दैट मीन्स हीट। Geothermal energy is heat from within the earth. Geothermal energy is generated in the earth's core almost 4000 miles beneath the earth's surface. The double layered core is made up of very hot magma. Basically, magma is a melted rock surrounding a solid iron center. Very high temperature are continuously produced inside the earth by the slow decay of radioactive particles. This process is natural in all rocks. Surrounding the outer core is the mantle, which is about 1800 miles thick and made of magma and rock. The outermost layer on the earth, the land that forms the continents and ocean floors, is called the crust. The crust is 3 to 5 miles thick under the ocean and 15 to 35 miles thick on the continents. The crust is not a solid piece like the shell of an egg, but is broken into pieces called plates. Magma comes close to the earth's surface near the edges of these plates. This is where volcanoes occur. The lava that erupt from volcanoes is partially magma. Deep underground, the rocks and water absorb the heat from this magma. We can dig wells and pump the heated underground the water to the surface. People around the world use geothermal energy to heat their homes and to produce electricity. Geothermal energy is called a renewable energy source because the water is replenished by rainfall and the heat is continuously produced deep within the earth. We won't run out of geothermal energy. Geothermal energy is defined as heat from the earth. It is clean, renewable resource that provides energy in around the world. It is considered a renewable energy resource because the heat emanating from the interior of the earth is essentially limitless. The heat continuously flowing from the earth's interior is estimated to be equivalent to 42 million megawatt of power. The interior of the earth is expected to remain extremely hot for billions of years to come, ensuring an essentially limitless flow of heat. Geothermal power plants capture this heat and convert it to energy in the form of electricity. The picture below shows the source of geothermal electric power production. Heat from the earth. As depth into the earth's crust increases, temperature increases as well. In this particular figure, you can see the temperature with the depth of earth. Temperatures in the earth, it is given in Fahrenheit and related to the depths in mile. Around 2500 miles, temperature is 7200 degree Fahrenheit. As goes in depth, 4000 miles, it is around 9000 in Fahrenheit. So this is some representation of temperatures in Earth with the depth. Like all forms of electric generation, both renewable and non-renewable geothermal power generation has environmental impacts and benefits. Now, converting the geothermal energy into electricity. How we are going to convert the available geothermal energy into electricity? This is very important thing. Heat emanating from the earth interior and crust generates magma, that is molten rock. Because magma is less dense than surrounding rock, it rises but generally does not reach the surface. Heating the water contained in rock pores and fractures. Wells are drilled into this natural collection of hot water or steam called a geothermal reservoir in order to bring it to the surface and use it for electricity production. The three basic types of geothermal electric generation facilities are binary, dry steam, which is referred as a steam, and flash steam, referred to as flash. These are the three basic type of geothermal electric generation facilities. Electricity production from each type depends on reservoir temperature and pressure, and each type produces somewhat different environmental impacts. In addition, the choice of using water or air cooling technology in the power plant has economic and environmental trade-offs. The most common type of power plant to date is flash power plant, which with a water cooling system, where a mixture of water and steam is produced from the wells. The steam is separated in a surface vessel, that is steam separator, and delivered to the turbines, and the turbine powers a generator, simply in other power plants. In a dry steam plant, steam directly from the geothermal reservoir runs the turbine that powers the generator, and no separation is necessary because wells only produce steam. Figure shows a flash and dry steam plant. In flash steam plant, you can clearly see that hot water is coming in flash tank. Steam is directly entered into the turbine, and turbine is directly coupled with the generator to generate electricity. After generator, from the turbine, condensed steam or water is coming out. This is what basically the flash steam power plant. In dry steam power plant, from the figure it is clear that steam is directly entered into the turbine without using the flash tank. And through turbine, generator is rotating and generate the electricity. And after the expansion in turbine, condensed steam come out from the turbine. So this is all about the flash steam power plant and dry steam power plant, which is as similar after the flash tank and before the turbine. After the turbine, all the process is as similar to the conventional power plant. Recent advances in geothermal technology have made possible the economic production of electricity from lower temperature geothermal resources. At 100 degree centigrade to 150 degree centigrade, known as binary geothermal plants. These facilities reduces geothermal energy's already low emission rate to near zero. In the binary process, the geothermal water heats another liquid such as isobutane that boils at a lower temperature than water. The two liquids are kept completely separate through the use of heat exchangers used to transfer the heat energy from the geothermal water to the working fluid. The secondary fluid vaporizes into gaseous vapor to the steam. The force of the expanding vapor turns the turbines that power the generator. Power the generator, that means it rotates the generator to produce the electricity. If the power plant uses air cooling, the geothermal fluids never make contact with the atmosphere before they are pumped back into the underground geothermal reservoir, effectively making the plant emission free. That means they are not directly contact with the external agencies. These are developed in 1980s. This particular technology is already in use in geothermal power plants throughout the world in areas that have lower resource temperatures. The ability to use lower temperature resources increases the number of geothermal reservoirs that can be used for power production, and figure shows a binary power plant. This particular figure shows the binary power plant. Here, hot water, then binary vapor, that means it is through any media it comes into the turbine. As before discussed, the secondary fluid vaporizes into gaseous form, this one. And from this binary vapors, turbine rotates and coupled with the generator to generate the electricity. Then this binary liquid come back to the heat exchanger, and again this hot water heated it and come back as a cooled water. So this is the complete process of binary power plant. A cooling system is essential for the operation of any modern geothermal power plant. Cooling towers prevent turbine from overheating and prolong facility life. Most power plants, including most geothermal plants, use water cooling system. Here in figure below shows a complex diagram of a geothermal plant complete with a water evaporative cooling system. Figure simplify the process of electricity production. While figure shows greater detail and accuracy, water cooled system generally requires less land than air cooled systems and are considered overall to be effective and efficient cooling systems. The evaporative cooling used in water cooled systems, however, requires a continuous supply of cooling water and creates vapor plumes. Usually some of the spent heat from the turbine for flash and steam type plants can be condensed for this purpose. Air cooled systems, in contrast to the relative stability of water cooled systems, can be extremely efficient in the winter months, but are less efficient in hotter seasons when the contrast between air and water temperature is reduced. So that air does not effectively cool the organic fluid. Air cooled systems are beneficial in areas where extremely low emissions are desired, or in arid regions where water resources are limited. Since no fluid needs to be evaporated for the cooling process, air-cooled systems are preferred in areas where the view shed is particularly sensitive to the effects of vapor plumes. As vapor plumes are only emitted into the air by wet cooling towers and not air cooling towers, most geothermal air cooling is used in binary facilities. In this figure, you can see the geothermal power plant with water cooling system. Steam is coming from the geothermal zone to the turbine, then generator. After expansion in turbine, it comes to the condenser. Then water is circulating through the cooling towers. The expansion from the turbine, it comes to the condenser and the water, then it go back to the resources. Here in the cooling tower, after cooling, that water is come back to the injection well, and air and water in the form of vapor come out from the cooling tower. So this is all about the geothermal power plant with water cooling system. It is as similar to the conventional thermal power plant where cooling tower is used for cooling the medium. A combination of flash and binary technology known as the flash binary combined cycle has been used effectively to take advantage of the benefit of both technologies. In this type of plant, the flashed steam is first converted to electricity with a back pressure steam turbine and the low pressure steam existing the back pressure turbine is condensed in a binary system. This allows for the effective use of air cooling towers with flash applications and takes advantage of the binary process. The flash binary system has a higher efficiency where the well field produces high pressure steam, while the elimination of vacuum pumping of non-condensable gases allows for 100% injection. So this is all about the power plants which is used for generation of power through geothermal energy. This technology is not in very popular, but still in recent times it is going to be popular by utilizing different technologies added in a specific way. So this is all about the geothermal energy and how we are going to use this energy to generate the power. So thank you very much.